Our technical journey into reinforcement learning will start by learning the Jim API. And the first order of business is to install Jim. Follow the instructions in this video to install Jim on your system. To have access to all the simulations provided by Jim, we need the package called jimall in third brackets. As of 2021, there are many ways to install this package, most of which do not work. Windows is not officially supported, and official instructions are non-existent. On Linux and Mac, you do get official installation instructions, but you soon realize that you need to install tons of system libraries. And this list may be different depending on which distro you are using. Luckily, there is an alternative way to install Jim using Conda, which is painless and uniform across operating systems and distros. And it looks like this. You install the system requirements first, and on Windows, this means we need to install the latest version of Visual C++ build tools and Miniconda. On Linux and Mac, we only need Miniconda. And then to install the package, we set up a Conda virtual environment and then let Conda do the heavy lifting for us. I will now take you through these steps. On Windows, we first need to install the latest version of Visual C++ build tools. And for that, you should visit this URL. And I have put this URL in the video description. In this URL, you should try to find the latest stable version of Visual Studio, which at this point of time is this one, Visual Studio 2019. And then go down in the download section and look for the tools for that Visual Studio version. And inside that dropdown, find the build tools for that Visual Studio version. So right now this is Visual Studio 2019, as I said, the latest stable version. But when you do it, this might change, so you need to choose the build tools for that version at that point. Okay, so let's download that. Save the file, then open it. Now the installer will ask you which component you want to install. And for our purposes and for this course, we only need the desktop development with C++ component. So we will tick that and then hit install. So once you have the latest version of Visual C++ build tools installed, the next step is to install Miniconda. The Windows installers for Miniconda are on this page, and I will also put a link to this page in the video description. So in this page, go to the Windows installer section, and then you will find a list of Windows installers corresponding to different Python versions and architecture, 64-bit or 32-bit. So how do you choose the Python version? Well, we need the highest Python version, which is supported by all the packages that we will use in this course. And in this course, we are going to use the Jim package and TensorFlow. And Jim supports Python version 3.6 to 3.9 currently. TensorFlow also supports Python version 3.6 to 3.9 currently. So we are going to choose the highest one supported by both, which is Python 3.9. So this is the installer for Python 3.9, and my computer is 64-bit, so I'm gonna download this one. Save the file, and then open the installer. And then simply choose the default options until you have installed it, okay? So once you have installed Miniconda, you will find that you have access to something called an Anaconda prompt. which is here. So simply open it and type conda list. If you get an output, this means Miniconda was successfully installed in your computer. And therefore, we have satisfied the system requirements for installing Jim on Windows. On Linux and Mac, we only need to install Miniconda because that's the only system requirement. So just like the Windows installers, the same page lists the installers for Mac and for Linux. And for Mac, we should install this version. And for Linux, we should install this one. And since I'm on Linux, I'm going to download this. Once you have downloaded it, go to the folder where you downloaded it and then make that file executable for the user. Right? Once you have made it executable, just run the installer. So usually we will just choose the default option. So here it asks us to press enter. So I pressed it. And then you get the terms and conditions. Then you say yes to that. Choose the default location for installation. And then it should ask you whether you wish the installer to initialize Miniconda by running conda init. So answer yes to that question, and this will make sure that your shell can execute conda commands. It will also ask or suggest that you execute this command so that the base environment is not activated by default when you open your shell. And I think that is a good suggestion. So we will just copy that command and then restart the shell. And then use that command. Then restart the shell again for it to be applied. And then type conda list, just like we did in the Anaconda prompt in Windows. And once again, if you get an output like this, fantastic, it means Miniconda is installed in your system. The next steps are the same for all operating systems. So I'm going to show it here on Linux. The only difference is that on Windows, you should use the Anaconda prompt to run these steps, while on Linux or macOS, you can use the vanilla terminal, like I'm doing here. So first, create a conda virtual environment by typing conda create and then name it RL course, reinforcement learning course, so that you know that this environment is for this course. And once the environment has been created, then just activate it by typing conda activate RL course. Once it is activated, you will see the name of the virtual environment or the conda environment next to the terminal prompt. And now to install Jim, simply type conda install -c, that's for the channel, and we will use the conda forge channel, and then the name of the package, which is jim-all. And this is going to take a while. And that's it. Jim is now installed with all the available simulations on your system. And you can start using the package right away by typing import Jim.